We can do debugging of TypeScript directly by putting breakpoint. Like we would do C# code debugging, we can do TypeScript code debugging with breakpoints and watch windows and autos windows and so many other features. So to set up, we will need either Visual Studio 2015 or Visual Studio 2017. That is what I am going to use throughout my course. I am going to use a Visual Studio Community Edition, which is absolutely free. You can also Google Visual Studio 2015 or the latest is Visual Studio 2017 Community Edition download. Search for this particular phrase and then download that, install it, and we are up and running. So to later, if suppose you are planning to go for Angular application development using TypeScript, you will need compulsory minimum TypeScript 2.2 version or higher, of course. So for that, you'll have to download and install the latest version of TypeScript on your machine. So visit this URL, or if the URL is no more valid at the time of you watching this video, simply Google TypeScript for Visual Studio and it will directly take you to this link, and you'll have to download and install it. That's it. You should already have Visual Studio on your machine. After that, you have to install TypeScript SDK for Visual Studio. Whichever is the latest version, use that. If suppose you have already got the Node package manager on your machine, you can install TypeScript latest version by going to command prompt and putting npm install -g TypeScript. But of course, prior to this, you should already have Node package manager existing on your machine. So if Node package manager is not there, you can again go to Google, search for Node package manager installer, set up that for Windows machine, and after that run this. Suppose you have already written a TypeScript file, and if you want to do command line compilation, you can do like this. If it is only one file, just say tsc.exe. Assumption is the tsc command is in path. Then only this tsc.exe would work from anywhere. If not, you'll have to search where is tsc.exe on your machine, and then from that directory you have to execute the tsc.exe command with the ts file. Or if you want multiple files, you can give multiple files with an option of specifying only one JS file. So you'll have multiple TypeScript files, but in output we are going to get only one JS file. Of course, here for one TS we are going to get as output one JS file. And what is this command? If suppose you write this, the advantage is every time you make a change to this and save it, automatically it is going to compile the output with minus watch option. So just saving the file is sufficient. TSE will immediately compile and generate the latest JS. So we are going to, of course, make use of Visual Studio. As I said, go to Visual Studio. First, verify if your Visual Studio already has TypeScript or not. Go to About, and you'll see here we already should have TypeScript. Should be last. TypeScript 2.3 is installed in my studio currently. Now we create a new project here, ideally new website. Empty website is good enough. My first demo. Some empty template will be created. A web application is going to be created because we need to execute the HTML file. I'm going to add here now a TypeScript file. Let's say demo.ts. Now in this demo.ts, we can write a function, something like function. See the IntelliSense beautiful feature. Hello world, or say hello. We can declare here a variable message. Colon string is equal to some hello, let's say hello world, and this I would like to display in alert the message. Semicolon is an optional statement terminator like in JavaScript. So this is just a function. Here only I can call the function. But to execute this TypeScript, we need to first have a JS file generated, and also we need to have this JS file included in a HTML page. Small spelling mistake. Now, let us add to the project a HTML page. Let's say demo.html. And in demo.html, we select the TS file, drag and drop, and you'll notice that Studio has generated script tag, but it has replaced TS with JS. So now if I run, I'm going to make demo.html as the start page and run this, Control F5. And we'll see hello world. The TypeScript code got executed. Through this, the TypeScript was included. But was it TypeScript which was actually included? No. You'll notice that in the same folder now, we are going to have open folder in File Explorer. We are going to have a JS file. So we can say edit the JS file. And let us compare the TypeScript and the JS. We'll see almost everything is same. Just that here we have the data type which is missing in case of JS. So this is the source TS. The compiled output of that is the JavaScript. Now, this is one small example. So let us take one more example. I'll add one more file, or we can probably edit the same file with one more function. So I have now, or I'll make changes to this function itself. Let us say I would like to have first name string and last name. You see, I'm declaring data types for them, and I'll have message, and to this message I would like to append hello first name and last name and alert. Now what is important, you see, this is giving compilation error. That is a beautiful thing here. Why it is giving compilation error? It is expected to have two arguments that we are not given one. So give here, let's say my name Sandeep and Sony. So same program, we have just added proper data types here. Yeah, we can also say colon string. With colon string, what is the meaning? We can return a string now. So return, let's say message. So if needed, we can remove this alert from here and put alert here now. Now run the program. So what is the difference? We came from a simple function with no parameters to a function with parameters. Important thing is, for every parameter we are mentioning the data type, and we are also mentioning the return type here. So let's run the program now. Hello Sandeep Soni. Now can these values be taken from text boxes? Yes, you can always do that. You just program in HTML the way you would program in any other normal JS file. Like that only you'll have to do it.